Thank you. one.
Rock of ages, clear for me. Let me hide myself here.
Let us all rise as we sing hymn 50.
Kom ons buig ons hoofde vir 'n oomblik van gebed. Vader in die hemel, baie dankie vir u genade en u liefde. Dankie Here dat ons u kan aanroep in hierdie uur van droefheid. En dankie Here dat ons in ons hartseer die lewegewer, die een wie vir ewig lewe, ons roep en pleit u teenwoordigheid met ons vanoggend. En u seën op die program van vandag. In Jesus naam, amen. Ons sal op hierdie stadium geleentheid gee, u mag maar sit. Vir die van u wie moontlik nie geleentheid gehad het om die liggaam vir die laaste keer te besigtig, u sal nou die geleentheid kry om dit wel te doen.
Goeiemôre. Welkom vanmôre in die 7de dag Adventiste Kerk. Sit stil en rustig, as u is meer as welkom vanmôre. En ons glo vanmôre dat almal van ons wat vanmôre hier is, is hier vanmôre om medelee te betoon aan die Miller familie. Baie dankie.
Once again, greet you in that wonderful name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. And if we can turn to the Word of God, I want to share a few scriptures with you from the book of Proverbs, Proverbs chapter 4. So I'm going to read from Proverbs chapter 4, reading from verse 10 to 13 and 20 to 23. I'm reading from the New International Version. And the heading in my Bible is Two Ways of Life. Starting from verse 10, listen, my son, accept my words, and you will live many years. I am teaching you the way of wisdom. I am guiding you on the straight paths. When you walk, your steps will not be hindered. When you run, you will not stumble. And I'm reading from verse 20, and the heading there is the straight path, the rechit weg. My son, pay attention to my words. Listen closely to my sayings. Don't lose sight of them. Keep them within your heart, for they are life for those who find them, and health to one's whole body. Guard your heart above all else, for it is a source of life. I pray that we will receive comfort as we will listen to the word of God this morning. Amen. May God bless.
Ek nooi u om te staan as ons gaan sing die eerste lied, 430. 430.
vir 'n tribute vir Kylan Davids na vore nooi. Kylan Davids vir 'n tribute.
Good morning, friends and family. I stand before you this morning to pay a tribute to a friend, a brother, a cousin, a loved one. Nachim. Vas die woord wat Obas vreeslik gebruik het. No one knows the origin of when Nahi started. He was introducing me to someone one day and he said, "This is my Nahi." And everybody started laughing. And ever since then, he's always used the word. Paying tribute today to someone who was a legend in many people's lives. In Proverbs 17, verse 17, a friend loves at all times, and a brother is born in a time of adversity. There's a lot of people who can sit here today and attest that Kurt was not just their friend, he was their brother on many a times. There's so many people who spoke at his memorial service, and they attested to the fact that Kurt was there. Hy was 'n staatmaker gewees. You could literally call on his number anytime. I could phone Kurt and ask for advice while in Joburg. Nagie my kar wel is dat. Nie nagie hierdie kar lelik gery. So many times where he would speak and he would just say, "Today is your right name." And he wasn't one to hide away his fears. He wasn't one to also hide his emotions. He constantly played music. He lived his life through music. And he would say, "Ja, die song praat weer vandag met my." We stand, I think the last one of the conversations we had a conversation about death. And I said to him, we live our lives as if we know what tomorrow brings. Did we really think that we would be sitting here today to come and bury Kurt Müller? Did we think that we would be sitting here? We live and we think that we have immortality, and we hardly ever fathom the fact that the journey on this life is one that is so short. But if lived right, it is an amazing opportunity. So we stand here today, we sit here to pay tribute. When you look outside, when I looked last night, when I looked as we were driving up, there were cars and there were people, and I saw number plates from here and there. When a legend falls, people come to pay their last respects. When a legend falls, to my aunt, you have lost a son in a million. You have lost. Our family has lost, the community has lost, his family has lost. But we take solace and we stand on the foundation of the word of God. And so vas aan die woord van die Here. Kurt Müller, Obas, my last nagie. What a life, what a legacy. Say not in grief that you are no more, but in thankfulness for the life that you led. Today we will rest in peace. A legend in our family, the glue and the bondage that actually always kept us together. May his soul rest.
Thank you, young Mr. Kylan Davids. At this time, we'll call Naledi Madira forward to do the obituary. Thank you.
Goeiemôre, Alba. Obituary of Kurt Obas Cecil Miller. Kurt Cecil Miller, known as Obas, son of Sylvia and the late Georgie Miller, was born on 7 December 1979. He was the second eldest and son. He started his educational journey at Joe Solomon Primary School and completed his grade 12 at Heatherdale Secondary School. After he matriculated, he worked for a short period of time for Engine Parts and Telkom and furthered his career at Transnet in Bloemfontein. He later decided to join the family business. Kurt will always be remembered as a hardworking person. He was a humble person and always willing to lend a helping hand. Kurt will be dearly missed by his mother, his two sisters, his two brothers-in-law, five nieces and one nephew. Nahi will surely be missed. Rest in peace.
Dankie, Naledi. Om aan te gaan met ons program, sal ons die Colbert Cousins na vore roep vir 'n spesialiteit. How do I say goodbye to what we had? The good times that made us laugh outweigh the bad. To see forever, but forever's gone away. It's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday. I don't know where this road is going to lead. All I know is where we've been and what we've been through. Ooh, if we get to see tomorrow, I hope it's worth the wait. And it's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday. And I'll take with me the memories to be my sunshine after the rain. It's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday. And I'll take with me the memories to be
sunshine up to the rain. It's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday.
Thank you, Colbert family, for that beautiful rendition. We'll invite Kurt's sisters, Clydeen and Janice, to do a tribute to their brother. Clydeen, thank you.
Die ys is gebreek. Goeiemôre vriende. En familie wat van ver gekom het, vriende. Ek het vanoggend seker voor 2 eers in die bed gekom en ek lê die hele tyd in die bed wakker en ek het op my foon begin tik, wat wil ek van my broer sê, en ek vra myself, wat sê ek van my broer wat almal nie alreeds van hom al gesê het nie. Daar is so baie om van Kurt te sê. En ek wil nie repeat wat mense van hom gesê het nie. My broer was 'n goeie mens. Hy was my vriend. Hy was my boeta. Al was ek die oudste. Ons het 'n spesiale bond gehad. Net soos hy 'n spesiale bond met Nelly gehad het. Ek was met vakansie nog in die Kaap en toe ek die boodskap kry. En soos die spreekwoord sê, dit het soos 'n doodstyding gekom, dit het regtig soos 'n doodstyding gekom. Dit was so onwerklik. Ek het hom gistermiddag het ek en Nelly na hom gaan kyk. En het mooi gelyk. Maar kon nie lang na hom kykie, want ek het myself gesê, dit is so onwerklik. En ek het vir my skoonsis gesê, ek het genoeg gesien, ek gaan hom nie vandag gaan kykie, maar ek het gevoel, dit is my laaste, kom ek gaan. En toe ek hom vanoggend sien, toe sê ek vir myself, hier is nie my broer nie, want hy het nie soos my broer gelyk nie. Maar ek berus my daarin, die Here weet van beter. Ons weet nie hoekom en waarom nie. Ek was kwaad. Ek was en ek is nog stikkend. My suster is stikkend. Sy seer. My ma is stikkend. Sy seer. En ons weet nie hoe ons hierdie seer gaan hanteer nie. Maar ek berus my daarin dat die Here ons sal dra. En net soos ons halfpad die pad gestap het met hierdie se heen gaan, glo ek die Here gaan ons dra met hierdie heen gaan. Dit was 'n groot, groot skok, nie net vir ons as familie, as ons breër familie nie, maar vir die hele heidetal, die hele gemeenskap. Ek kan sien, ons het hierdie week en 'n half het ons besef en agtergekom die voetspore wat Kurt agtergelaat het. Hoeveel mense hy geraak het. Hoeveel mense in hom belang gestel het. Ek en oupas het nog het so baie oor gepraat, net soos ek en my pa. Ons het baie serious conversations gehad. Ek kon van easily sê, maar wie wat, jy praat nou soos het was, of jy redeneer nie reg nie. En hy was nie een wat vir my gesê het, ach weet jy man, hy het die wereldse respect vir my gehad. Ek onthou 'n geval, toe ons nog klein was. Baie van u weet dat George Miller is my, nie by my biologiese pa nie. En my van was eers Harms op my ouma se van. En Nelly en Kurt was Miller. Hy het altyd gevra, hoekom is Pinkus Harmse en nie Miller nie? En eventually het mami vir hom gesê, en ek het hy naweek by jou vriendin geslaap, en vroeg hy maandagochtend voor ek terugkom huis toe, toe by al die foon, en hulle roep vir my en sê, jou broer is op die foon, hy wil gauw met jou praat. En dier die slaap, hy vroeg vir hom, opas, wat is voelt ons slaap nog? Hy sê, my sister, hy het my so gebrei, gehad, nee? Hy sê, my sister, ek wil net vir jou sê, ek ken die waarheid. En ek staan daar, dier die slaap, ek vroeg vir hom, opas, waarvan praat jy, die mense slaap nog hier? Hy sê, mami het my die waarheid vertel van jou. Ek vraag wat? Nee, jy is my daddy se kindie, maar weet jy wat nie, jy is my sister. En sinds die dag, het hy my altyd getreed, asof ek sy eie was, even Nelly ook. Ek is ewig dankbaar, dat ek a relationship met hom kon gehad het. As hy verkeerd was, kon ek met hom praat. En hy sal nooit vir my gesê het, moe nie vir my kom vertel nie, hy sal my nie skeef aangekyk het nie, hy sal uit my die respect as sy ouwe sister gegee. En het altyd vir my gesê, moe nie waar nie my sister, dinge sal reg kom, ek gaan dinge reg maak. Hy was baie lief van sy kinders, hy het altyd gesê, ek het 6 kinders, 5 neeses en 1 nephew, ek het 6 kinders. Maar ek wil die verder tyd, in beslag neem nie, want daar is baie wat ek van my broer kan sê. Ek sê net dankie vir die Here, dat ons allemaal wat hier sit, die voorreg gehad het, om 'n rol in sy lewe ook te kon gespeel het, en dat hy voetspore in ons lewens kon agtergelaat het. Baie dankie.
Goeiemôre almal. Kom. Een paar maanden geleden. Sorry. Een paar maanden geleden. In diezelfde kerk. Ik en mijn zuster ook. Samengestaan. Sinds vijf mijn daddy. Ik heb die dag. Met mijn daddy afgestorven. Het gevoel, my lewe is gebreek. Dan kom het net 6 maande daarna, en my broer word so lelig van ons weggeruk, voel ek. En ek, van my, my sister en my mami, ek voel hy is weggeruk van, ek was baie, baie lief vir my broer. Ek was so lief vir hom. Die twee mense, die twee manne in ons middelfamilie is weg. En kyk net wat doen hulle los vir ons vroukies maar hier alleen. En hoe gaan ons nou maak? Dat so ek voel. Maar my daddy was altyd daar. My broer was altyd daar vir ons. Maar wat gaan ek my mam en Pinkus nou doen sonder hulle? Ek gaan nie baie van my broer praat nie. Almal het alles gesê wat needed be for good. Vir Boeta. Ek wil sê my broer was 'n warme kop hoor. Hy was lief vir bekleier en alles. Hy was lief vir vinnig ry, en as jy staan met hom ry, dan kan jou hart uit jou spring van die man ry vir jou soos hy al drywe. But, met al sy goeikies, was hy die beste. Hy was so die beste. Hy het altyd gesê vir my, Nelik, jy wat nie, mense is jealous op ek en jy, wie jy hoekom? En niemand het sy relationship soos een broer en sister soos ek en jy. Ons gaan vandag strui. En ons gaan vandag opmaak. En die dag wat die afsterwe doen, onthou ek sy woorde. Hy die oogend wat die dinsdag afsterwe my nog een boodskap gestuur en vir my gestuur, hoe lief is hy vir my. Ek vat dit as my goodbye, my broer. Ek voel net, ek is stikkend. Maar ek sal seker maar wei kry om oor dit ook te kom net. Ek wil net vir allemaal sê, my ma het die beste seun grootgemaak. My pa het haar werkende man grootgemaak. En ons het die kans gekry om sulke goeie broer te hê in ons lewe, ek en Linkus. Ek hoop hy weet hoe lief is ons vir hom. Want ek weet nie of hy weet nie. Maar dis al wat ek wil gesê van my broer. Dankie.
Amen. Dankie Kleitien en Nelly. Volgende op ons program, van nog een special item, sal ons vir Jack van Delistraat na vore nooi. Jack.
Ek wil een dankie sê vir die voorrecht vanoggend wat julle my gee. Dankie vir die familie. Ek gaan sing, dankie aan Sylvie. Maar ek gaan een bemoedigende woord sing. En dis omdat die Here lewe kan ons uitsien na môre. So, die droefheid is daar. Maar ons sal mekaar definitief eendag weer ontmoet. As die organman is of wat. Misschien vir my kan uit, ja. Maar sê nie, nie. Dan moet ek maar sing. Omdat hy leef, sien ek uit na môre. Omdat hy leef, kan ek die toekomst sien. Omdat hy leef, ja, hy leef, sien ek die toekomst. Die lewe is die moeite werd, omdat hy leef. Because he loves, I can face tomorrow, because he loves, all fear is gone, because I know, yes I know, he holds the future. And life is worth the living just because he loves. Because he loves, I can face tomorrow. Because he loves, all fear is gone, because I know, yes I know, he holds the future, and life is worth the living just, 'cause Jesus lives.
Op Baie geleentheid, sê ons baie dankie vir Jack. Ons gaan nou na vore roep, hy is nou nie op die program nie, die president van die PA, Kit was ook een groot PA, lid van die PA. Ons gaan vir ons sal na vore roep vir die president van die PA, Keitan McKenzie. Is Keitan hier? Kom ons sing maar so lang, because he loves, I can face tomorrow. Voel of ons die hele dag net kan sing tot eer en verheerliking van die naam. En vir pastoor maar net so net een kans geef, so twee woorde en maar die hele dag sing tot alles voorbij is. Maar ongelukkig, ons het nou net bevestig dat Keitan is by een meeting. So, ons gaan maar voort met ons program.
Jesus lewe. Keitan mag ons teleerstel, maar die Here lewe. En hy is altyd met ons. Ons hoop, hy sal 'n geleentheid hê om iets te sê. Maar op hierdie stadium wil ek leraar Tyson na vore nooi, want hy is ook in ons midde. En hy staan as het ware tussen die lewendes en die dooies. Sy vrou is ook hierso. Sister Liz, baie dankie dat u vir leraar gebring het. Hulle ken vir Kurt vanat hy baie klein was in die sabbatskool hierso. So ons glo, hy uit vir ons 'n woord van die Here wat ons meer as gaan vertroos. Leraar Tyson, mag die Here ons seën.
Jammer dat ons weer ontmoet onder sulke treurige omstandighede. En sister Sylvie, net weer eens ons innige meegevoel. En het is nog nie eens 12 maande nie, toe ons Georgie tot rustig geleid. Maar sy het geweet Georgie gaan sterwe, weens sy siekbed. Maar sy het nooit verwag dat sy vandag weer hier sal sit om die enigste seun te begrawe. Nie een van ons het dit verwag nie. Die lewe is so onseker. Sterkte vir jou, Sylvia, Nelly, Claudine, die res van die familie. Ja, nie, ek ken Kurt hele klomp jare alreeds. Ek kan goed onthou omdat ek 30 jaar in die bediening is en ek het hier begin. So dis 30 jaar wat ek om ken. En ja, dis net skokkend dat hy nie meer daar is nie. Maar Kurt het 'n geleentheid gehad om sy lewe te lei. Net soos ons een en elkeen nog daardie geleentheid het om ons lewe te lei. So vandag gaan ons nie so seer praat oor Kurt nie. Maar Kurt het baie vriende gehad, ons kan sien hy's baie jong mense. En my hart gaan uit na jong mense. Ek het ook self 3 dogters. Al 3 is nou getroud. En daar's 5 kleinkinders. En ek is nou afgetree, officieel, vanaf Oktober. En ons beplan vir die kleinkinders, hoe ons gaan kamp en hoe ons gaan toer. Om hulle bietjie weg te hou wanneer hulle vakansie is, weet jy dan aan die kinders net met die iPads of die pads of wat jy ook al noem. En ek wil ouers aanmoedig, hoe langer jy hulle kan weghou van daardie technologie, hoe beter gaan dit vir hulle wees. I shared with you some verses in the book of Proverbs chapter 4 from verse 10 to 13. It speaks there about, my son, accept my words, so listen to my words. Verse 20, my son, pay attention to my words and listen closely to my sayings. Don't lose sight of them, keep them within your heart, for they are life to those who find them and health to one's whole body. Now, I would like all of us to have a very special experience here this morning. Because I've conducted many funerals, and not only many funerals, but only many wedding ceremonies. But let's stick to the funerals. And it's a certain fact that many people who attend funerals, they leave the same without a change. Now, Kurt's death made this meeting possible. And I'm going to do injustice, not only to him, but also to God, if we do not address certain things. Because at the time, something happened in Kurt's life as well, that he was not so committed any longer to the Lord. And there are many young people today who take life for granted. They're young and healthy. Their life is lying ahead of them. They will grow old and then they can serve the Lord again. And I just want to warn our young people today. None of us has any degree that we will be alive tomorrow. 2 weeks ago, a man decided that he wanted to go for a massage. So he arrived, and when he arrived there, He just said, I'm not feeling well. They allowed him to go to the restroom. He collapsed. And he died. A couple went to visit their daughter, their son in Australia. And they wanted to return back to South Africa. They arrived at the airport. And just before they could board the plane, the wife collapsed. She died. Just like that. I mean, Kurt went to clean the graveyard or the grave of his father. And then while busy there, he wasn't feeling well. And they took him to the hospital. And he died. Therefore, I'm saying if each one of us can have this experience as recorded in the book of Isaiah, chapter 6, Isaiah with a broken heart because his beloved king passed away, died. So it says, in the year of that King Uzziah died, I saw also the Lord sitting on the throne. May you this morning have a clear vision, seeing the Lord on the throne. High and lifted up, and his train filled the temple. Above it stood the seraphims. Each one had six wings. With twine he covered his face, and with twine he covered his feet, and with twine he did fly. And one cried unto another and said, Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. And the post of the door moved, and the voice of him that cried, and the house was filled with smoke. Then said I, and this is the experience because we are in the presence of the Lord, our God, our Creator. And this is an experience that we should have here this morning. Then I said, woe is me, for I am undone, because I am a man of unclean lips. And I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips, for my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. That experience to realize that you're a sinner in a lost condition, you need a Savior, and as you see God sitting on the throne, that you will confess your sins. And not only confess, but be willing to forsake them. Then the next verse says, and he laid it upon my mouth and say, lo, this has touched thy lips, and thy iniquity is taken away, and thy sin purged. And when the words was uttered, who will I send and who will go? Said, yea, am I, Lord. Send me. Now, that verse 13 in Proverbs chapter 4, not verse 13, verse 23, guard your heart above all else, for it is the source of life. Now, when the Bible speaks about heart, it means your mind. Because let me tell you, we make choices in life that will influence our eternity. And then there's nobody to blame. Sometimes children want to blame their parents or other people. But you yourself need to take control of your life as a person. I pray that you will do a mind change. Today, You know, there is nothing so powerful than a mind change. To change your direction. If you want something out of your life, if you want to change your ways, if you want to overcome bad habits, Kurt is lying here today because of habits he acquired. He should have been a lifestyle. Death is not from God. It's our circumstances in life and our life choices that lead to death. Because the Bible promises us long life. You are supposed to be alive still. As a young man, he had dreams. He was still looking forward. And I must say, he was a nice guy. He was humble. He was respectful. But there were certain habits. And I want to tell young people today, wrong habits will claim your life. Wrong habits will kill you. And that's why the Bible tells us the devil is after you to get our young people like a roaring lion. And therefore, you must get it right here in your mind. If you want to live a successful and a long life, it's a choice that you need to make yourself. If you want to overcome wrong habits in your life, it's going to be hard, it's tough, but you can do it by the grace of God. You just need to step up. Look at yourself. Ask yourself a few questions. You know, I myself had to do that many years. I was 18 years old and in matric. And the plan for my life was, I'm not going to be a nuisance to anybody. I'm going to get a job. When Friday comes, I will buy myself a few beers and just have a good weekend. That was my plan. But I thank God that I met Jesus Christ. And I made up my mind that that is not the life that I want to live. Because you will never know where that one puff, that one drug, that one glass of beer, where it will lead you, where you will end. You know, young people and all of us, we need to raise our standard of living. High standards. Don't live like the people the devil wants us to live in this world. This world and its things will soon come to pass. We need to live for eternity. You know, I think many of us, we know successful people. We were talking about Mackenzie. He was in one of services in Mayville Church. So I know him some years back. as we are gathered here, all of us can be successful in this life. You know, successful people are rewarded in public for what they have practiced in private for many years. It doesn't come overnight. And therefore, I want to encourage our young people, like the songwriter says, the hymn writer, I'm pressing on to higher ground. Not on what the world offers us, but I'm pressing on to higher ground. And let me tell you, don't give up on your dreams. Dream. Because dreams today, they're just the seedlings of what we're going to reap in the future. Aim high. Dream big. If you're not going to reach the moon, at least you will land on one of the stars. If people criticize you and say you won't make it, tell yourself, I can. I will make it. Amen. I'm not going to waste my life away. You know, but nothing comes easily, especially in the times that we are living in. You know, nowadays, young people, they want things easy. They want to get a job and they want to earn that salary now. They don't want to climb the ladder. It doesn't matter where you start. If you need to start at the bottom, be humble. Press on. Set your goal. You know, there was a man called Darby, a young man living in the same era as a great inventor, Edison. He grew up in a poor home, but he made up his mind. He made a choice, a decision here. He was determined that he will make it in life. So he said to himself, I am going to Edison, not to ask for a job. I'm going to Edison to tell him that I want to be a co-worker with him. Now that's powerful. And Edison, years back, Darby eventually became an assistant to Edison. Because he made up his mind and he burned all the bridges behind him. And that he's going to do this one thing, to become an associate of Edison. Edison said the day he walked into his office, Darby looked like a tramp. But he looked into his face and he could see the determination. And he just gave him a sweeper's job. But after 6 years, he was an associate of Edison. So young people, even if some people look down on you because of the situation you find yourself in now, because of criticism, you must make up your mind. And not only to be successful here, but that one day you will be in the kingdom of God. So you must hold on in spite of everything. You know, the reason why many mess up their lives today, it's because they do not have a purpose for their life. Now I want to tell you that there's a purpose for your life. God doesn't create junk. God has a purpose for your life. And because God has a purpose for your life, you must live a purposeful life. Find your purpose. Find your purpose. If you don't know it, and you just go aimlessly through life hoping that tomorrow will be better, it won't happen. Or ask God to show you, God, what is the purpose for my life? You know, the human spirit is powerful. That inner force is powerful. Our young people today can be an unstoppable army. In our political world, if you think back of 1976 and those years, our young people was a force to be reckoned with. They can still be that force today. I want to tell our young people, just get your priorities right. Put first things first. Don't take your life for granted. You know, many of us go through lives with brakes on. Stop, go, squeaking. In the book of Jeremiah 29, verse 11, a wonderful verse. But you know what thoughts I have concerning you, says the Lord. Not to harm you, but to give you hope and a future. It means to prosper you. Young people, God have plans for you. To prosper you. You know, the whole purpose of existence is growth. It makes my heart so sad when I notice, I witness not only young people but many adults as well. They've become stagnated. They've lost purpose. And it's easy to pick up. I mean, if you stay in bed till 12 o'clock, midday, you've got no purpose for your life. If you become stagnated, you won't grow. And if you don't grow, because that is the law of nature, to cease to grow is to perish. Did you hear that? To cease to grow is to perish. And that's why I've made up my mind a long time ago. I will rest the day I will die. It's not hard work that kills. It's stressful lives that kills. At 65, I'm still very active. A young man phoned me now the other day in the week. He said, Pastor, I can't keep up with you. I had to load something and my back was sore. I want to tell each one of us, not only young people, though adults as well, every day you need to accomplish. You know, sometimes children want to make an excuse. Life is boring. Life is not boring. Life is not boring. You must get a purpose, find your purpose for life. Every day there's something to do. And let me tell you, because the unemployment rate is so high, but do what you can do. Even if you clean the yard, pull out the weeds, do something. And then we look back and say, this morning there was such a lot of weeds there, and look now. And tomorrow you start to plant something there. The point is, every day you need to accomplish. God grants us 24 hours a day, each one of us. And one of these days you will give an account of how you have spent your time, God's time. Today, some young people just waste time, hours. Some adults as well. It's with the cell phones, it's with games, in front of the television. They waste their time. Let us count each second, because when it's gone forever. This life that we live now is the only life that God has granted us to be profitable, to make an impact on the lives of others. Because we do not live for ourselves. We are not islands. You know, young people, your future is in your hands. And your mind is the master of your body. Because in Proverbs 23 verse 7, as a man thinketh, so is he. And therefore, this morning, I want to ask you, make that mind change here. If you read in the book of Romans chapter 12, where it speaks about the lifestyle. Let this mind be in you. That mindset. So we must be industrious. There's a verse in Acts 17 verse 28. It reads as follows. For in him, who said? Jesus Christ. We love and move and exist. So many today want to live a life without Christ. But the Bible tells us in him, in Christ, we live, we move, we exist. Never ever live your life or think you can live your life without Christ. If we read in the book of Psalm, This quarter we are studying Psalms. And all the prayers in the book of Psalms. But in Psalm chapter 1, verse 2 and 3, it reads as follows. And what I'm referring to as well is that we should be industrious. We should prosper. Psalm 1, verse 2 and 3. Blessed is the man whose delight is in the law of the Lord. If you want to be successful in life, put Jesus first. Obey his commandments. Blessed are the men whose delight is in the law of the Lord. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth fruit in season. His leaf also shall not wither. And whatsoever he do shall prosper. I want to encourage you. Today is the day that you need to make a mind change, that you will allow Jesus Christ to be part of your life. And Jesus gives us life in abundance. I want you today to affirm the good, that which is true. If you do that, evil will vanish. You know, it's like turning on a light when it's dark. When you switch on the light, then darkness disappears. Before I share some other good news, really to give you hope for the future and what you will not find in this world, but in the future, I came across this during the week. Listen carefully, and maybe it was Kurt's thoughts or reasoning as well. You are well. That's fine. You hope to remain that way. That's just natural. You may be disappointed. That's possible. But one sure fact is, you will die. That is sure. The next line says, you better get ready. Then that's wisdom. You want to be right? That's promising. Yes, you want to be right, that's promising. But you don't know the way. Then, this morning, I'm saying to you, listen. Listen. Accept. Believe. And receive. Because this world is not our permanent home. We're just passing through. Therefore, in Hebrews 4, verse 9, there remaineth a rest for the people of God, not just for anybody, but there remaineth a rest for the people of God. This earth, our brethren and sisters, family members, if we have hope in Christ, Christ for this life only. The Bible tells us in 1 Corinthians 15 verse 19, then you are the most pitiest of all people. This life is not the only life. This life is full of trouble, of sorrow, care. This life is full of anxiety, labor, and toil. This life is full of losses and bereavement, partings and separation, mourning and woe, sickness and pain. This life, like Elijah, he cried out to God and said, God, let me die. Yes, if we think this life is everything, we, the pitiest of all people, miserable. We must look beyond this life. We must look beyond this life. Beyond the silent, cold grave. You know, I thank God that this life is not all. You know, and that's what keeps me going as well. And it should keep each one of us going, knowing that this life is not all. For me, whatever I experience in this life, my circumstances, for me, it's always the best is yet coming. I'm not going to give up. I'm not going to throw in the towel. I'm not going to let the world and the devil mess up my life. And the Bible speaks about that clearly. If you read in 1 Corinthians 15, I am going to read 1 Corinthians 15, listen to from verse 1 to 4. Now, brothers, I want to clarify. Now listen carefully. This is the word of God. This is the word of God, the true gospel, as it is from Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. 1 Corinthians 15, I'm reading from verse 1 to 4. Now, brothers, I want to clarify. I want to clarify. I want to set things straight. I want you to understand. For you, the gospel I proclaim to you. What does it say? For you, the gospel that I proclaim to you. Now, in the times that we are living in, preachers, instead of lifting up Jesus, they want to lift themselves up. And people look at preachers. They follow preachers. But the Bible tells me, the gospel. I want to encourage you today. Spend time for yourself to read the word of God. The gospel, which is the truth of your salvation. Speaks about the gospel. Proclaimed to you. Then it says, you received it. You know, many of us, we listen. It goes in by the one ear and out of the other ear. And tomorrow we just carry on with life as usual. But let me tell you, there's coming a day that you will cry out to the Lord God. But then the Bible tells me it will be too late. Now is the time, as you hear the gospel, that you embrace it, you receive it, and then it says, and have taken your stand on it. You know, not on all these things that are proclaimed today that we listen to. You know, we watch these video clips. where some pastors feel their congregants must lie down and they stand on them. Some proclaim and you can drink, and while let's have a good time here with the wine, alcohol. Some tell people, I just went to heaven and I've seen the promised land. Sell your property and give your money to me and I will secure a place for you there. And people are so gullible because they do not know the word of God. So the Bible speaks about the gospel. Receive it. Take your stand on the gospel, what's written. And not just what you, some people just go to church and they feel, at least I've been in church, I've listened to the preacher, but they never open the Bible for themselves. You need to read the Bible for yourself, because it says here, if you take your stand on it, verse 2 says, you are also saved by it. Let me tell you, there's no shortcuts. I want to talk to you about heaven just for a short while. There's no shortcuts to heaven. You need to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. You need to love the Word of God. You need to live according to the Word of God. You take your stand on it. You live according to it. It's a lifestyle that you love. And you will be saved by it. It says, the last part of that verse, if you hold to the message, today everything goes. And the world out there want to point finger to Christians. But we just proclaim the message. It's expected of us. Jesus, I am the Word who became flesh. You cannot proclaim false doctrines and still claim that you're proclaiming Jesus Christ. Stand firm on the Word of God, even if you're alone. Young people, even your friends mock you. You stand on the Word of God. And the Word of God is powerful, and the Word of God can change you. And then it says, the message I proclaim to you, unless you believe, to no purpose. For I pass on to you as most important what I also received, that Christ died for our sins. You need not to die in your sin. Christ died. That's why there's a wonderful verse in the book of Hebrews. Chapter 9, verse 27. It's appointed unto man once to die, and after death the judgment. That's in God's plan, our appointment with death, but only once. Well, the Bible speaks about the second death, but I'm not going there. If you read in the book of Revelation, blessed are those who have part in the first resurrection. Over them the second death has no power. Praise the Lord. Amen. That's why I do not fear death, because it's appointed unto us to die once. But we need to fear the second death. But Christ died for our sins, according to the scriptures. That he was buried, that he was raised on the third day according to the scriptures. Let me jump there to 12. Now, if Christ is preached as raised from the dead, how can some of you say there is no resurrection of the dead? You know, some people, and let us put it the record straight. Because it's in the Bible about the resurrection. Read the whole chapter of 1 Corinthians. Today, many people want to put their loved ones in heaven. Oh, the person is in heaven. No, Kurt is not in heaven, he's lying here in the coffin. Huh? Nobody goes to heaven when you die. Because that was the devil's first lie in the Garden of Eden. Eat of the fruit, you shall surely not die. And that's why some young children take their own lives, because they want to be with mommy or daddy who's in heaven. Now, the Bible tells us here, why are there some of you that say there is no resurrection? But if there is no resurrection of the dead, then Christ has not been raised. And if Christ has not been raised, then our preaching is without foundation, and so is our faith. And that's why, if death comes and knocks on my door, I will just welcome death. Welcome, because I'm ready. Because I have this assurance. The Bible tells us when Jesus comes back again, 1 Thessalonians 4, and the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. And we who are alive together with them shall be caught up and meet the Lord in the air. So shall we be with the Lord forever. Amen. Comfort one another with these words. And in the book of 1 Corinthians, there's coming a day when the dead will be raised incorruptible. This mortal shall be changed into immortality. So why should we fear death? We are not home yet. Just listen here to the faith chapter, Hebrews chapter 11. I'm reading verse 13 to 16. He is, verse 13, Hebrews chapter 11. Now listen to this. These all died in faith without receiving the promises. But they saw them from a distance, greeted them, and confessed that they were foreigners and temporary residents on earth. Oh, we're looking forward to better things. Temporary residents. There's load shedding. There's potholes. I drove through bad roads yesterday on my load shedding. There's death, there's sickness. The Bible says these all died. But their focus, they've cast their focus the year after. Verse 14 says, now those who say such things make it clear that they are seeking a homeland. Any of you who are foreigners here, you know, sometimes they give foreigners a hard time. But let me tell you, we are also foreigners here. Because we're seeking a homeland. This is not home. So verse 15 says, if they had been remembering that land they came from, they would have had the opportunity to return. But verse 16, but they now aspire a better land, a heavenly one. Heaven is real. First of all, the dead are not there yet. The Bible, if you read, maybe for instance, 1 Corinthians, 1 Thessalonians 4 verse 15. Those who are alive at the coming of Christ will not enter, will not precede, will not go through the gates before those who have died before. So if the living will not enter heaven before the dead, it means the dead are not there yet. Amen. We're still longing, but we're getting there. It won't be long. Jesus is coming soon. get ready. Now is the time. Because the Bible tells us, therefore God is not ashamed to be called their God, for he has prepared a city for them. Ah, there's a city. That's why in John 14 verse 1 to 3, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In the house of my Father, there's many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go, I will come back again to receive you so that you can be where I am. That is God's desire for all of us. But I want to tell you, you need to accept Jesus here and now in this life. You cannot long to spend an eternity with God in heaven if you do not serve God here on earth. No, in that heavenly city, heaven, faith will be swallowed up in sight. Hope in certainty, prayer in praise, sorrow in joy. Now we must endure hardness and we need to press on, faint and pursuing. Now we are tossed upon stormy sea, then we shall be safe at harbor. Now we have to battle, but then we will receive the crown of victory. Now we must need bear the cross, Sylvie, like Dean, Nelly, family members, bear the cross, but then soon we will receive the crown. And therefore the Bible tells us, blessed are those who die in the Lord from henceforth. Brethren, in this life, day by day, we experience sorrow. All of us, we are acquainted with sorrow. They take some of your things away and you are sorrowful. You lose your job and you are sorrowful. You know, you are encompassed with trouble, sickness, difficulties, and you are sorrowful. Our loved ones go down in the grave and we have sorrow. We are living in a sorrowing, grieving world. Blessed be God, there shall be no sorrow in heaven. There shall be no tears in heaven. There shall be no suffering and pain in heaven. And my question this morning as we conclude, I want to ask you, how is it with you? How is it with you if you should die tomorrow? Yes. Are you ready to welcome death? Is your name written in the book of life? There is a book of life. And I want to ask you, do you not want to consider this morning to give your heart to the Lord, to commit to the Lord, to make Jesus Christ part and parcel of your life? I want to encourage, do not postpone, because you might never see tomorrow. And therefore, always regarding these important things, salvation, by God is always today. Harden not your hearts. And I want to tell you, it doesn't matter who you are, maybe how bad you are, or your past. But what matters, just listen to this, is the invitation of Jesus. You read in Isaiah, listen carefully, Isaiah 1 verse 18, come, let us discuss it. Come, let us reason together, said the Lord. Though your sins are like scarlet, they will be white as snow. Though they are as red as crimson, they will be like wool. Let me tell you, don't give up on yourself. With Jesus, nothing is impossible. But just be willing to sit down and listen. Jesus, let us reason. Let us reason. We can work this out. Yeah? I will cleanse you. I will cleanse you from all unrighteousness. Now, listen to verse 19. If you are willing and obedient, you will eat the good things of the land. What does it say? If you are willing and obedient, you will eat the good things of your land. You know, many of us, we are reaping a harvest because of the seeds that we've sown. Miserable lives. We struggle in this life. But here it says, if you make right with the Lord, you know, for me it is, wisdom comes from God. Education we get from books and studying at varsity. And many of our parents who are uneducated, they make wiser choices than the educated people. So God will grant you wisdom to make the right choices. And verse 20 says, but if you refuse and rebel, you will be devoured by the sword. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. What I bring before you today, this morning, is life and death. And I encourage you, choose life. Choose life. Heaven is real. There is coming a day when no heartache shall come, no more clouds in the sky, no more tears that dim the eye. All is peace forevermore on that happy golden shore. What a day, glorious day that will be. What a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see. When I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace. When he takes me by the hand and leads me to the promised land. What a day, a glorious day that will be. There be no more sorrow there, and no more burdens to bear, no more sickness and no pain, no more parting over there, and forever I will be with the one who died for me. What a day, glorious day that will be. What a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see, when I look upon his face. The one who saved me by his grace, when he takes me by the hand and leads me to the promised land. What a day, glorious day that will be. I want to be there. I want to see you there too. And Kurt, we want to see him there too. May God bless. Amen. Amen.
En wat sê die kerk?
Amen.
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 Ons het nog 2 items. Ons wil vir Daryl 'n geleentheid gee en vir Kaylin. Daryl, ons gee vir jou eers geleentheid, as jy met ons iets wil deel. Dankie.
weet nie wat ek sê gemôre of moet ek sê goeiemiddag nie. En oh fuck. As ek nie oogkontak maak met julle vandag nie, is nie maar kom beskof ons nie. Ek het Gert se laaste oomblikke met hom gehad. Ek was die een wat hom gevra het en het tot vandag regret dat ek hom gevra het om saam met my te gaan naar die begraafplaats toe. Het was nie een makkelijke paar daar, of weet ek om sê, week plus nie. Want ek lewe elke dag soos een nachtmerrie wat hem elke dag herhaal. Ek sien hem elke dag. Ek sien die eerste oomblik en ek sien sy laaste oomblik as hy in my arm sterf. Baie sal sê, hy was sy neef, hy was sy broer. Ek en oppas het aan die bond gehad. Dinge kon gebeur, maar ons kon het weer uitstryk. Hy was nie perfect gewees, hy. En nog minder was ek. En seker omdat ons so na aan mekaar was, kon ons stry en kwaad wees vir mekaar. En ek op oomblikke wens, kan hy nie bel om verskoning te vra. En of ek om hy moet bel om verskoning te vra. Maar wanneer ons by mekaar gekom het, kon ons aan mekaar verskoning vra. En ons kon alles doen wat ons wou doen en weer. My vrou het langsam hier staan, blijf my sê, Daryl, om vrede maak met die Here. Want ek is nie vrede met die Here nie, ek sê jammer, ek sê dit vandag hier so, ek sê jammer, van hy dag af, het ek nog nie weer met die Here gepraat nie, en ek het nog nie een gebed of enig iets opgestuur nie. Of hom sê, jammer Obas, jammer ek jou saamgevat die dag. Dus allemaal sal sê, hy is een hardwerkende mens gewees, en so was hy. Ons het met Derry's graf, wat ingeval het, hier by Heather Heights, gaan regmaak. Ons het na dit, na my broer's graf gegaan, en dit reggemaak. Ons het Charlotte's, ne, ons het families, het my gesê, Basie, ek ons twee was, ek weet nie, sal ek sê, fortunate of wat so kal, maar op wat ons die name gegee, is nie doopname nie. Ek word ter baie geken as Basie, en hy as Obas, en dit is ons opa wat ons die name gegee het. Maar soos ons by die begraafplaas was, graaf reg gemaak, het hy gesê, terwyl ons hier is, kom ons, bly maar somme vandag hier so, asseblief. Ek sê, maar son raak warm op was, en hy sê, maar ons het dan vir die twee saamgebring, om ons te help. As die twee hier vandag is, sal ek in getuig en sê dat ons het familiegraf te besoek, en hy het gesê, kom ons dan na Albert se graf toe. Albert se graf skoon gemaak. My oma, my opa, ons het soveel graf dat ons nie eens meer kon tel, maar het aan die gang, hy is soos een machine, en ek het probeer by jou, in plaas van sê vir hom, kom hou nou op, en hy sê, kom ons gaan aan, hy sê, ek wil my daddy uitkom, ek wil my pa's graf uitkom, ons moet daar ook gaan recht maak, het hom gesê, is recht, sê hy, nader dan gaan ons jou kar regmaak. Ons het vergeet van hy kar vandag. As hy syfels is en as sal wat ook al sal ons doen, ek sal die dag verder uitstel by die werk. En ek het gesien die raak moog. En hy het gesê, kom ons drink iets man. Kom ons stuur vir dien twee. En vir dien twee weer teruggeroep, ons dien twee los alles. Ons sal sommer saam gaan. Soos ons begin loop, het ek gesien hoe swakker hy raak. Het mense wat besig was om 'n graf reg te maak en langs hulle was daar mense wat besig was met hulle eie dinge. En hy het na hierdie gegaan soos hy die mens was wat hy was. Hierdie wat ek en julle nie sal weggaan om water voor te vra nie. Het hy sê gee my water en die ene het gesê ek kan nie vir jou water gee nie man, die water is vuil, vat hy bottel. En hulle was besig om te rook of 'n ding, maar hy het nie omgegee nie. Hy het water gevat en hy het gedrink. Hy het gestap na die kar toe, hy het gekollaps. Hy het sê, o, wat maak jy nou? Ek het hom opgetel, ek weet nie waarvan die krag gekom het nie. En ek het hom binnen na die kar gedruk en ons het gery. Het gesê, ek is dors, krys my iets soet. Ons het by toon sitte gestaan. Van my kook gekoop wat ek tot vandag in my kasse net wat die kwart bottel van gedrink het. Het gesê basie help my, ek het gery, ek het mense die pad het gery, ek het lelik gery, het by die is gestop waar ek iemand net nodig gehad het om hom vast te hou en over daar gestaan het, my ma noem hom Gertjie. Hy het nader gekom en het gevra wat is dit. Hy het net sy voet in die kar gesit en ek het gery. Het gesê, hy kan my net saamvat en ek sê vir ons moet kyk wie hy achter in die kar. En hy sê, Here, niggie. Ons het by die hospitaal gekom, ons het gestop, ons het geskree vir hulp. Ek persoonlik is nie om judgment aan enige iemand te gee nie. Op hulle noem is hospitaal. Almal mag verskillende weergawe het van Pelonomi. Maar ek voel seker oor Pelonomi. Omdat my pa daar gesterf het. My broer daar gesterf. En ek het hom so intoe geras sonder om te dink ek gaan Pelonomi toe. Maar soos ek sê, ek is nie om judgment te lewer nie, maar ons het gestruggel. Om op 'n bed probeer kry, dadelik hulp probeer kry. Ek was in myself en ek het geskree. En het gekom en hy drup op kom sit. Maar hy het breie geskree. Basie help my. Basie skree, skeer op my wors, sodat ek my hart kan regdruk. En ek het hom gesê, jy gaan nou oké is. En hy het begin skree en het begin sê, waar is my daddy? Hy staan nie om die druk, hy sê vir my moet kom, hy kan my help. Daddy, kan my help my. Hoe sê ek vir hom? Daddy is die nie. Hoe sê ek vir hom, want hy dit weet ek nie, wat is bezig om te gebeur. Hy het stief begin trek, en het hom geswaai na my toe. Onse oor het gelok, asof ek dieper in hom kon sien, ek weet nie. En het afgesterf. Hulle het hom kom vat, ingestoot, wat hulle lank al moes gedoen het. en hom probeer terugbring. Maar hulle het nie. Is hulle vroeger as dit opgetree het. Vera is miskien een autopsie gedoen en alles het teruggekom. Wat was die uitslag gewees? Maar hy het te lang gelei. Jy sou nie jou vijand dit wou sien oorkom nie. Hy was my broer. Hy was my alles. En net so weet ek, hy was jylle sin ook. Maar my dankie, dat jy my oorreed het, want ek kon nie, ek het nie eens beplan om te kom vandag nie. Ek was so ver gewees het van jou, omdat hy miskien nog hier kon gewees het, en so weet ek, jammer, ek het om die dag kom haal. Ek is baie jammer, en ek wens ek kon dit terugvat. Ek wens ek kon dit terugvat. Ga jou mis. Ga jou baie mis. Bloemfontein sal nooit dieselfde wees. Nie vandag, nie morgen, seker van die Here kom. Ek het hierdig, maar het is so baie van muziek gehou het. Weet ek, het ek 1 jaar my broer afsterwe, was haar song wat ek gesing het vir hom, wat uit die diepte van my hart uitkom. Ek het nie voorbereid vir dit nie, maar ek gaan het anyway sing vir hom, om te sê, ek is jammer. Ek is jammer, ek kan jou nie terugbring nie. En dat ek jou nog gisteraand gevra om op te staan. Bewys allemaal verkeerd. Jy is nie weg nie. Ek is jammer, Roos. Ek is baie jammer.
Lily of the valley, let your sweet aroma fill my life. Rose of Sharon, show me how to grow in beauty in God's sight. Fairest of 10,000, make me a reflection of your light. Dear star, shine down on me, let your love shine through me in the night. Anywhere you open up the door, let your word speak to me, show me what I will never see before. Lord, I want to be your witness. You can take what's wrong and make it right. Day star, shine down on me, let your love shine through me in the night. for I've seen a world that's dying, wounded by the master of deceit. Oh, groping in the darkness, haunted by the years of past defeat. But then I see you standing near me, Lord, shining with compassion in your eyes. I pray, Jesus, shine down on me. Let your love shine through me in the night. Lead me, Lord, I will follow anywhere you open up the door. And let your words speak to me. Show me things that I've never seen before. Lord, I want to be your witness. Only you can take what's wrong and make it right. Day star, shine down on him. Let your love shine through him in the night. Jesus, shine down on him. Let your love shine through him in the
Leonard. Dankie, Daryl. Mag die Here jou troos. Kaylin, sê vir ons nog iets. Thank you, Kaylin. After this, we'll have the closing prayer.
He's the heart mender. He's the sunshine sender. And though you feel like your heart is broken in two, just give Jesus a chance. Let him through. He's the heart mender. Seem hopeless when you feel you've lost everything. From where you're standing, the rainbow is hidden. All you can feel is the rain. But it's alright to cry for a while, but don't let sadness bring you down. Have you ever thought of looking to Jesus? You'll be surprised at what you'd found. He's the heart mender. He's the heart. Though you feel like your heart is broken in two, just give Jesus a chance. Let him prove he's the heart mender. He's the heart mender. Is broken in two, just give Jesus a chance. Let him prove he's the heart mender. He's the heart mender. He's the heart mender.
Ons gaan nou die geleentheid gee vir Danny Titus vir die vote of thanks. Dankie Danny.
Goeiemôre familie, vriende. Groet u almal in die wonderlike naam van ons koning Jesus Christus. Om dankie te sê op die tyd is baie moeilik vir die gesin, want hulle het nie altyd die regte woorde nie. So ek staan hier vandag as 'n verteenwoordiger van Sylvia almal, om vir almal probeer dankie sê. Ek wil begin om dankie te sê vir die Here wat vir Kurt vir ons almal gegee het. Het is hy wat lewe gee, en het is hy wat vir Kurt in ons lewe gebring het. Almal hier vandag, die ervaring en experience wat ons met hom gehad het, was moontlik gemaakt deur die Here. So die eerste dank gaan uit vir die Here. En dan tweedens wil ek dankie sê vir almal wat die dag toe Kurt sy laaste gehad het met hom was. Daryl, ek weet, jy blame yourself, maar dit is jou skuld nie. Hy kon enige plek gegaan het. En so dan Sylvie sê, hy kon alleen gewees het. Maar jy was daar met hom. Dimpo, Sien, die ouwens van die Markie, wat gehelp het, baie dankie. Hy was nie alleen nie. Ons almal sal het graag wil treed kesjes, om saam met hom gewees het, van die laaste. So, dankie ons, dankie Daryl, moet net jou besiel, Fatih Bouta, is jou skuldie. Dan wil ek dankie sê, alhoewel, ons service delivery nie is wat het is, is daar medical personeel wat hulle beste gedraai het. So vir almal by Pelonomi, wie ewe wat dit is, dankie vir wat julle gedraai het. En julle wat ook nie hard genoeg gedraai het, dankie vir julle ook. Want elke hond kry sy dag. Die mense wat vir ons die begrafnis moontlik gemaak het, Twilight, elke familielid, jy weet, aan Sylvie, die hele week sê sy vir my, ek het nie geweet, Obas het so baie kerke nie. Nou, ek kan nou probeer om een lys by mekaar te skraf van al die kerke, maar toe sien ek, is al die kerke. So ek gaan niemand uitsonder nie. Elke groepie mens, elke groepie wat kut mee was, daar waar hy impak gemaakt het, daar waar hy mense kwaad gemaakt het, ek weet, ek het altyd by Lerico gegaan by hom, en dan is die eerste ding, nee man, Obas, hy begin altyd daar. Maar dit was die type mens wat hy was. En ja, pastor, ons weet, hy was nie die soetste oog gewees nie, maar Kurt sy hart was op die rechte plek. Kurt en om G het die quality, dat hulle kan nie iemand los om te sikkel nie. Hulle kan nie iemand los wat honger is nie. En so kom hy altyd met Nelly strijd, want hy wil die hele heide dal kos gee. Hy kom vat bleek kos, dan krijg hy weer iemand in die pad wat hy geëet het nie. Dan gaan hy weer terug huis toe, dan wil hy weer gaan kos haal. En dit is die type mens wat hy was. So Kurt het een impak in ons allemaal sy lewe gemaakt. Maak die saak wie hy was nie, of wat hy deur sy lewe gemaakt het nie. Die experiences het hom gevat tot waar hy was, maar hy het nooit gechanged as een mens nie. Ander mense is boemelaars vandag, maar Kurt was elke dag fresh. Ek sien hom vanoggend, en toe sien ek hom vir die eerste keer, sonder een hekat, sonder een trim, want hy was altyd, altyd in met die lijn. So baie dankie, Obas, Kurt, Mr. Miller, Easter, ons bra, ons gaan baie mis, maar soos pastor gesê het, een dag, hier is ons aan die waiting room nou, saam met ons hier en allemaal, en een dag sal ons mekaar weer sien, en ontmoet voor ons ingaan, in ons eeuwige plek. Baie dankie vir allemaal, aan Sylvie, baie dankie my auntie, ek dink, jy was meer sy rots, as enig iemand anders, en een ma, het altyd een speciale plek vir een seun. En ek het dit gesien. My aan Sylvie en Kurt. Maar kies ek kwaad sy vir hom was nie. Sam vir afwijnis, hy vir Obas ingeskip. Maar kies ek wat het hy gedoen nie. Waar is Obas? Is hy okay? Want Sylvie, baie dankie, my auntie. Jy het vir Obas elke dag rede gegee om op te staan en om sy beste te draai. En al het dit vir julle gebruik nie. In my oor, as Obas, as ek sês, ek sal nooit neer kyk op hom nie, want hy het baie gedoen vir ons allemaal, soos sy pa, en het getraai om soos om G te wees, maar hy kon nie die pijp rookie, maar hy het getraai, en ek wil dankie sê vir dit, het liefst vir die poging, dankie.
Ja, afgesluit sal ons al die draars na vore roep, Alfonso de Kwaker. Sorry, jammer.
Kom, laat ons net staan vir een slotgebed. Kom, laat ons allemaal staan. Hemelse Vader, selfs onder hierdie omstandighede, bring ons lof en eer tot u naam. En soos ons nou net gehoor het, wil ons u ook dankie sê vir die lewe van Kurt. Hy slaap nou, hy rus. En Heere, weer eens, bring ons die familie voor u, wil u hulle troos. Het is een moeilike tyd, maar ek vraag dat hulle een nauwe wandel met Christus sal hê. Ons een en elkeen, dat die Heilige Gees leiding neem, en ons voorbereiding vir die ewigheid. Jesus kom spoedig terug, dit gaan nie meer lang wees nie, dan gaan ons huis toe. So laat die Heilige Gees met ons wees, tot daar die wonderlike dag. Amen.
Kan die draars net na vore kom, Alfonso, John Fries, Ashley Adams, Ted Goeieman, Isaiah Menores, en dan Kurt Jacob. Kurt, oké. Okay.
Die vrienden gaan het beter, alle vrienden wat ik wil doen.
Thank you. Voordat ons begin, daar is 'n versoek, as daar kinders is wat op stoele sit, miskien kan ons hulle vra om op te staan en plek te maak vir die ouer mense. Asseblief kinders, we are about to start, and I want to take your attention to the program, because on the program there is a hymn entitled Until Then. Sis Dri Twia, Until Then.
My heart can sing when I pause to remember how I take you in a pink stone along a trail that's winding always upward. This troubled world is not my final home. But until then, my heart will sing. Until then, with joy at every one. Until
Almagtige Vader in die hemel, ons dankie dat ons op hierdie oomblik op die naam kan roep. As we stand around this open grave, our hearts are torn, we are numb with grief, and we call upon you because you are our help, you are our strength, you can carry us through this, you know the pain of death. You understand a broken mother's heart. You understand the mourning and the grief of family members, of friends. We gather together this morning and we come humbly into your presence asking for you to comfort us. You are the way, the truth, and the life. Guide us, O Lord, because we cannot see the way after this. Help us to understand truth, truth about life, truth about eternal life. Help us today as we say good night and not goodbye, that we will know you as the life giver. Choose you today so that we may have the assurance of seeing our loved ones who have fallen asleep in Christ. Now as your servant speaks and does the committal, please bless and use him in a mighty way. May we be attentive. May your spirit minister now in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I believe there's a special song that we will lower the coffin.
Verses from the book of Job, chapter 14, for encouragement. Job chapter 14. Just the verse here. Job chapter 14, from verse 10. But man dieth and wasteth away, man giveth up the ghost, and where is he? So the waters fails from the sea, and the flood decayeth and drieth up. So man lieth down, and riseth not, till the heavens be no more. They shall not awake, nor be raised from their sleep. Verse 13. Oh, that thou wouldst hide me in the grave. Oh, that thou wouldst hide me in the grave. That thou wouldst keep me secret until thy wrath be past. That thou wouldst appoint me a set time. He will never forget his children. Jesus himself said, I've engraved your names in the palms of my hand. And then it goes on. If a man died, I could, you can close this grave now. The question is asked, shall the dead rise again? And the good news is, answer is yes. Yes. When the Lord comes. Amen. So it was those thoughts, as God has in His infinite love and mercy has permitted our dear brother Kurt to fall asleep in Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. We now commit his body to the earth, dust to dust, in that sure and glorious hope of the soon coming of Jesus Christ, when Jesus will raise the dead from the graves. Amen. Let's bow our heads as we pray. Heavenly Father, as we are standing around this open grave with broken hearts, we know that your heart is also broken. And looking down from heaven, this was your child, Lord, but he's resting in peace now. He's not going to experience any more trouble like we have trouble in this world. And I pray, Lord, that you will be with Sister Sylvie, you will be with Nelly, Claudine, the rest of the nephews and nieces, aunts and uncles, close family members, and especially his friends as well. As we can see, at many friends, so we thank you that you have granted him that opportunity to gather such a lot of friends around him. Bless them in a special way too. And when Jesus comes, we pray that you will remember this prayer. Let your Holy Spirit abide with us now until that day when we will meet our Savior in the clouds. In his name we pray, amen.
Amen.
At this time, we will call upon close family members just to draw closer to show the last respect before we close the grave. So you can just make your way. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. bid. En ons vraag die familie om nader te staan. En die ruiker bring, dat op die graf gaan kom. Kom ons sluit die oë in gebed. Vader in die hemel, ons het nou gedoen wat bestem was vir hierdie dag. Dankie vir die krag. Dankie dat U ons gedra het tot nou toe. Here, ons ken nie die toekoms nie, maar ons weet, die een wie ons gedra tot nou toe, ken die toekoms. En daarom vraag ons, Vader, dat U ons sal lei van hierdie plek af, en as het U wil is, Here, dat ons mekaar weer sal ontmoet op daar die blye dag, die groot dag van die Here, wanneer hy sal kom, om hulle wie in hom gesterwe het, hulle wie vir hom gelewe het, hulle wie vasgehou het aan die geloof tot die einde toe, dat hulle gaan opwek. Hou ons getrou tot daardie dag, Here. Seën die familie, omvou hulle met die arms van liefde, en laat hulle nie alleen. Dit bid en vra ons in die groot naam van ons koning Jesus. Amen. Daar is vir elkeen een klein verversing voorbereid by Heide Primêre Skool en dis waar ons volgende gaan ontmoet.
Don't believe me.
One love.
No, no, no. hopeless sinner who has hurt all mankind just to save his own. Believe me,
one love, one heart, let's get together and feel alright.
As it was in the beginning,
one love,
so shall it be at the end.
One heart,
alright,
give thanks and praise to the Lord, and I will feel alright. Let's get together and feel alright.
One more thing, let's get together to fight this holy Armageddon.